everyone, welcome to another bonus episode of the New Marketing Show, the marketing podcast where we talk about how effective digital marketing and web development solve business problems. So today, you know what? Let's talk about landing pages and what makes for a good landing page that's going to yield a high conversion rate. So the first thing, the first and foremost, when you're creating a landing page, you want to minimize the amount of distractions on page. So, you know, a lot of times, you know, people want to go for a fancy design. They want to go for different things with a lot of like images and graphics and whatnot. I say get right to the point. Get to the point, use a catchy headline, let people know why they're on that page, first off. So typically a landing page, they're going to be drawn to it from some sort of ad campaign or a boosted post or something like that. So what I always want to do is I want to make sure I deliver exactly what I promised them. So if they're coming for, you know, maybe a promotion, you know, make sure that the ad and the landing page correlate with one another, because that way you're going to start building trust and they're not going to think that you're bullshitting them. The second thing, have bullet points. Put your value proposition and the features and benefits within bullet points. People don't read anymore. They scan text. They scan copy. The biggest thing that you need on any landing page is a form. Put a form on the page. Make sure that the form is easy for people to fill out. Make sure you're not asking too many questions, because if you ask too many questions and try to get all the information, you know, I remember seeing Tim Ash a long time ago of Site Tuners talk about how marketers are really greedy and they want all the information. Well, you know what? Just get what you need to get them into your system and to get them and for you to get permission to contact them. And then from there, you can go for, you know, the full ask of information or whatever. So make sure you have a form that works, and make sure that the form is not one of these long forms. Remember, they're not filling out a car loan. They're not trying to get a mortgage. You're just trying to get some basic information. What I like to do when forms on my landing pages is I like to get their name, have a drop down for like what they're interested in if there's multiple options. And then also the key conversion point that I do is I put in one field phone or email. So they can give me a phone number or they can give me an email, because that also allows me to remove one question, which is how do you prefer to be contacted by me? So if they put a phone number, you're gonna make the assumption that, and it's an intelligent assumption, that they're gonna wanna be contacted by phone. If they put an email address, you're gonna figure out that, hey, they wanna be contacted and communicated with an email. So if you have a synopsis of your features and benefits and bullet points, a good headline that delivers what you promised, and then also a form that works, most of the time you're gonna be way better than anybody else. The last thing that you want is testimonials, some kind of symbols of trust and proof that people do use your product, it does what it says it does, and that will also yield a higher conversion rate. So give these couple things a try on your next time you create landing pages and see what happens. So, hey, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching us on Instagram TV. Really appreciate it. You can get our full-length podcast on Tuesdays at trinitywebmedia.com/iTunes. See you next time.